Hi, how are you? Matt Watson here from CarWow. Got a question for you. What do you think will happen in a drag race between the new BMW M4 competition, a Mercedes AMG C63S Coupe, and an Audi RS5? Well, we're going to find out because I'm going to launch them and time them over the standing quarter mile. So let me tell you about this BMW M4 competition. It has a 3-litre twin-turbo straight-six engine with 510 horsepower and 650 newton metres of torque. It's rear-wheel drive and it's got an 8-speed automatic torque converter gearbox with launch control. This car's quite heavy. It weighs in at 1,730 kilos. It's quite a lot, isn't it? And it's quite expensive, £76,000. That Mercedes, it has a 4-litre twin turbo V8 with 510 horsepower and 700 newton meters of torque. It's got a 9-speed multi-clutch automatic gearbox with launch control. It's rear wheel drive. In terms of weight, the Mercedes comes in at the same as this BMW M4 competition, 1,730 kilos. A bit more expensive than this though, £77,000. Finally then, we come to the Audi. It's got a 2.9 litre twin turbo V6 with 450 horsepower and 600 newton meters of torque. It's got an 8-speed automatic gearbox with a torque converter with launch control, and it drives all four wheels via a quattro all-wheel drive system. It's actually the lightest car here, despite being all-wheel drive, whereas the other two are rear-wheel drive. It comes in at 1,715 kilos. It's also the least expensive, at £67,500. Anyway, let's get on with this very German sporty coupe drag race, yeah. Anyway, let's race.
Yeah.
Buying a new car? Then head to CarWow, and my team will help you find your next car at a fair price. CarWow, your one-stop car buying comparison site.
Now, before we race, let's do the obligatory CarWow sound check. I'm going to start off with this M4 competition. It's pretty loud in here. But I know they enhance the noise with the speakers. Real noise, just amplified. Mercedes V8, do you think? Are you in race mode?
Race mode, but there's a soft limiter, as per usual.
Oh, soft limiter, not here. Oh dear, poor you. Let's have a listen to the Audi RS5. There's got to be a soft limiter in that. Wait a minute, the Audi has no soft limiter and it sounds the best. Has that got a standard exhaust on it?
It may have an aftermarket exhaust, yes, and it is incredible. I can feel it through my seat.
Well, there you go. I don't think we need to vote which sounded the best because it's quite clearly the Audi with its aftermarket exhaust. A little bit disappointed by the Mercedes. It'll be fine when it's running though and that soft limiter is removed. Let's do it. Let's race. Bogged down a bit. That Audi's just gone. I'm struggling for traction. This track is a little bit wet. Can I come past the murk? Yes. Can I catch the Audi? I'm gaining. Both me and the Mercedes struggled there. Hey Mercedes, we've got the same problem, haven't we?
Yeah, it goes and then it just cuts all power and then eventually comes back in.
3, 2, 1.
Oof. Struggling off the line, the Audi's gone. Now I'm taking the Mercedes. The Audi's too far ahead. Do you know what? The Audi is launching on the dry side of the track, yet it has quattro all-wheel drive. Me and the Mercedes, we've got rear-wheel drive and we're on the damper patches. So let's have a bit of a reshuffle. Right, we've switched things around now, so me and the Mercedes are on the driest part that we possibly can be. Doesn't matter where the Audi is, it's fine, whatever. Let's see if this helps.
3, 2, 1.
I've got a good start then. We're struggling for traction. Come on, BMW. I've got the Audi. Mercedes ain't even in it. What a beautiful, 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 beautiful race. Here comes the Mercedes now. First off, let's talk about the Mercedes. What is the problem?
As soon as it gets any slip, it just cuts power. Even traction fully off, it just won't allow any wheel spin whatsoever in launch.
It is what it is. I've had that problem before with Mercedes, the rear drive versions. Audi, this time, my friend. Now I'm not on the damp patch. I beat ya.
Yeah, I've got to hand it to you. That was phenomenal. This thing took off like a rocket, but you absolutely tore past.
I mean, it's so good. Like the old one would just struggle. It would just spin up its tyres. This one really manages the slip. It didn't hook up perfectly, but once it got going, you had no chance. This is immense. Oh, victory! Yeah, you can thank me later, BMW fanboys. In fact, thank me now in the comments.
So then what exactly happened? Well, the BMW did the standing quarter mile in 11.7 seconds. The Audi took 12 seconds, and the Mercedes, with its consistently poor start, took 12.9 seconds to do the quarter mile.
Now we can have a rolling race from 50 miles an hour. The car's in automatic mode and comfort. Let's see what happens. We're going to count in. 3, 2, 1, go. Kick down, come on. God, this was slow to kick down. That Mercedes was off. Can I catch him though? Come on, BMW. Come on, don't run out of runway. Don't run out. I'm passed and I'm braking hard. Breaking neck. Now, I'd like to think that even though the Mercedes gearbox kicked down much quicker, I did just come past you before I chickened out. Do you concur, Mercedes?
Yes.
Good.
Just. But you did chicken out, so it's a kind of a 50-50 on that
one. And there's loads of runway left, but when you get in at that speed, a few seconds can make a difference on it.
Yeah, massive.
Audi? You were kind of neck and neck for a very short period of time. Our gearbox has probably responded pretty similar, but then our engines didn't they?
The gearboxes might have been on point, but I couldn't keep up with you.
Right, let's take the kick down of the gearbox out of the equation and see what happens then. Let's do it. Okay, now we have a rolling race, this time with the cars in their sportiest setting in third gear, manual mode. You ready, guys? On me. 3, 2, 1, go. This picked up good. Oh, it's struggling for traction. Come on. Now we're on it. Look at that. Oh my God, BMW fanboys just jizzing like crazy in the comments. Well, I think you guys got thrashed.
Try one more time.
I think you guys got thrashed. She was right. I needed to try one more time.
Don't want to piss on your bonfire, but I didn't think this was going to shift up automatically, and then I shifted, and then it shifted again, so I went up 2 gears. That's why. Sorry.
So basically, you cocked it up, right?
Sorry. I didn't quite
understand.
Could you repeat that? Back.
I think it's lost the plot.
I didn't quite understand you again.
Maybe these example commands might help you. I should work on my recognizer.
Maybe the concierge services can help you with this topic. Should I connect you to the concierge services?
Cancel.
All right.
Bonkers. All right then, let's do it again. Locked in third gear, manual mode. Let's do it. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, sorry for traction. Come on, BMW. Goodbye, Mercedes. Who needs a V8 when you got a BMW straight six? Well, there we go. How is your shifting this time, Mercedes?
This time at bot on, it can't keep with that power you've got though.
Really made little difference in it. This is just quicker. And how about you? Over there, Audi, nice of you to join in at the last minute.
It felt like the pickup between this car and your M4 was pretty similar again, but as soon as the speeds start getting up way above 100, I'm just a spectator, aren't I?
Yeah, I suppose you're going to have more drivetrain losses, aren't you, if I'm being all geeky, because that's four-wheel drive, blah, 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 but really, this engine is immense. Okay, now we have a brake test from 70 miles an hour when we reach the line, full emergency stop. The left foot brake, though, it's a bit awkward in this car because it's got like this lump in the middle of the seat, which looks cool. It's fine when you're just driving normally, but when you want a left foot brake or launch, it gets right in your thigh. I know this car stops really well. Got to win this. Come on, M4. Do the biz. Here we go. So, BMW beats the Mercedes. Definitely. Though I'm not sure if I beat the Audi. So the word on the street, well, actually from the cameraman who's on the outside looking at this filming it, is that I didn't beat the Audi. I'm not sure though. I think we're gonna have to move the Mercedes out of the way, please. Move it forward just a touch. This is a get out time. And the cameraman is insisting that the BMW lost that, but I'm not convinced. And he's measuring it from the back. It's not the back that you measure it from. Shut up about being on wet patches. You're always on a wet patch, you. The BMW won that.
No, it didn't. Are you joking?
Go on, have a look.
That's BMW.
Yes! Yes!
What are you
seeing? Wait there, pass me the camera. Look, this is the cameraman, right?
Why are you looking
at the back?
Look at the back of it. Look at the gap there.
But the back doesn't matter. It's the front. What is going to hit something?
It's the back that we usually judge it on.
It's not. It never is. It's never the back. It's not.
Okay, all right.
The back crossed the line.
This is why he's the cameraman, okay? Right, I'm going to get back in my car. Oh, my God. It's not when Usain Bolt's arse goes over the finish line, it's when his head or chest does, isn't it? Hope you enjoyed this video. Anyway, thanks for watching.